Hello again, YouTube and Yahoo 360. It's Nate again, and I've got another little spiel about Ron Paul to go through here really quick. I'm going to try to get through this one without rambling too much. I noticed today a few things about Mike Huckabee's campaign. Well, first of all, let's just say that Ron Paul made history this weekend. He raised more money in one day than any political candidate has ever raised before in any election, period, in one day. He raised over $6 million, and it's the only confirmed case now. Hillary Clinton supposedly raised $6 million, but it's not really confirmed. So this is the only confirmed case of someone raising $6 million or more in one day, ever. And that's pretty significant. It's a pretty significant event. But Mike Huckabee got more coverage in the press today. And, you know, that's fine. They cover what they want to cover. I think they're kind of missing a big story here, and they're not doing a really good service to their viewers. One thing I did notice about Mike Huckabee today was that he had a commercial where he is sitting in front of a cross, or what looks like a cross, and it seems to be sort of a, you know, subliminal advertising move there on Huckabee's part. He's not really saying it's a cross, but obviously it looks like one. Also, I noticed on the internet today, on HucksArmy.com, a little open letter to Ron Paul supporters, and this letter really left me feeling dirty in a lot of ways. So let me just read this to you. Maybe the guy that wrote this is a good guy, but somehow the tone of this letter just kind of left me feeling bad. And so here it is. It's an open letter to Ron Paul supporters. On December 16th, 2007, you made political history, raising over $6 million online in a single day. If Ron Paul were to win the nomination, the credit will no doubt go to his passionate grassroots supporters and their incredible energy online, and deservedly so. Then, on December 17th, 2007, we, Mike Huckabee supporters, launched our own grassroots fundraising drive. Within hours, we received wave after wave of false pledges from obviously fake email addresses referencing perverse sexual acts, insulting Mike Huckabee, and, you guessed it, telling us to vote for Ron Paul. Viewed symbolically, December 17th might have been the bigger day. Okay, why is that exactly? December 16th is the Boston Tea Party. What is December 17th? I don't get that. Okay. If Ron Paul doesn't win the nomination, there will be no one more to blame than many of his own supporters who give the very idea of freedom a bad name because of the way they abuse it. You may liken yourself to American revolutionaries, but your behavior is more reminiscent of Nazi tactics, sending in hooligans to break into and disrupt political rallies for their opposition. Mike Huckabee also has a strong grassroots campaign. Nevertheless, we have always endeavored to communicate respect and goodwill for our opponents and their supporters. Just as Mike Huckabee has done throughout the campaign, I have personally written letters congratulating you on your successes. In essence, we have two strong grassroots movements, one characterized by anger and cynicism, and the other characterized by compassion and hope. You got us beat in money and organization, but the difference in the ballot box may boil down to character and the way it is presented. This is America by Brett Harris, founder of HucksArmy.com. He goes on down at the bottom to say, I'm not sure where you got the idea that we are trying to compete with your money bomb. Mike Huckabee has never raised as much money as the other candidates, and he has never needed to. Ooh. So basically, the tone of this letter, it sounds very holier than thou to me. Okay, he's saying, yeah, you guys are angry and cynical, and we're compassionate and hopeful, and we would never do this to you. And you know, we don't need all your money. We're gonna beat you anyway. It seems to be the message that I'm getting out of this. But and also that you know, somehow we're abusing our freedom. Now, I don't see how you can abuse your freedom by speaking freely. You know, abusing, I don't get that. What is abusing your freedom? Is that committing some sort of crime? You know, I mean, if you put together a fundraising drive and you didn't get any money and you got all these insults, and so now it's the fault of Ron Paul supporters, because obviously you know they're the ones who did it. And is that the reason why you didn't get any money? I mean, I'm not getting this. It's like, you know, suddenly the focus is not on the fact that the fundraising effort failed. The focus is on the fact that you got some nasty emails, and so now it's our fault, and we're the bad guys and you're the good guys. You know, it doesn't make any sense to me. And, you know, it's pretty insulting. It's pretty insulting and condescending. And, you know, you're making a lot of assumptions here that just aren't warranted. How can you assume that, you know, the people are really all Ron Paul supporters? And, you know, it's just very unseemly to me. And, you know, I got to say, if you're running a website and you're putting together a fundraising drive and you get some insults or somebody's taunting you, so what? You know, that's not going to stop your fundraising drive. That's not really a big deal in any way. I mean, who cares? You know, I mean, look, on December 16th, they had a lot of false pledges for that too. You know, I mean, you think somebody from Giuliani's camp didn't log on and say, you know, Ron Paul sucks or something like that? I'm sure they did. You know, the Blimp Project, for instance, I know for a fact they had a good number of false pledges. They had a lot of people that didn't come through, that gave fake email addresses or whatever, you know, and nobody cared. It wasn't a big deal, and we don't know if it was Huckabee supporters or Giuliani supporters or Santa Claus supporters. I mean, there's no way of telling, you know. And just because somebody said, well, vote for Ron Paul, that doesn't mean that it was a Ron Paul supporter. It could have been somebody from some other camp trying to make us look bad. I mean, who knows? You know, I don't have anything against Huckabee supporters in general. I don't have anything against, you know, any of them, but this guy, you know, he seems really off base, and it's like he's just attacking the Ron Paul supporters and accusing us of something that he has no proof of. And, you know, that really doesn't seem, that's pretty silly to me. I mean, come on. You get on the internet and you didn't expect to get flamed? I mean, what were you expecting? Did you expect everybody to like you? I mean,